Katropa, aka Big Boss Tita here today, guys, and we've got Pandora,
the next-gen decentralized ecosystem with a dual token model and an inclusive incentive structure for traders and farmers. So what's great about Pandora, guys, is it has an AMM, it has a decentralized exchange or DEX, it has NFTs and marketplace, and even has jackpots. Okay, so I'll explain that a little bit more later. So the concept of this, guys, is a lot like a combination of PancakeSwap and OpenSea. Now, before I go to explain further what Pandora is all about, let me tell you about the airdrop event that they have ongoing right now. Okay, so they have an airdrop event, guys, where they're actually giving away 150,000 worth of PSR. Okay, so like I mentioned earlier, they actually have two tokens. So PSR is their main token or their governance token, and there are actually 5,000 total slots up for grabs. Okay,
so Pandora launch is actually going to happen on April 16, guys, and that's also when they're going to take a snapshot to find out who's going to receive these PSR tokens. All right, and the PSR tokens is going to be airdropped on May 17, 2022, so you still have time to make it to this airdrop event. Now, guys, anyone with a combined trading volume of a minimum of $500 from January 15, 2022 to April 15, 2022 is qualified for this Pando drop.
Right, so to participate, guys, all you need to do is to connect your wallet and then choose whether you have MetaMask, Trust Wallet, or Wallet Connect. And if you have the transactions, guys, okay, it's going to show here if you are eligible.
So if you want to participate, make sure to go to their website and check out the Pando drop, because you still have time for that.
So now, guys, on to the juicy stuff. What makes Pandora so special? So like I mentioned earlier, apart from the many features that Pandora has, I mean, on top of all those, is it has other great features or sub features as well. Pandora actually has an automatic market maker and an exchange. So this is where traders can actually swap tokens and pay swap fees. And in return, guys, is they can earn token rewards for every transaction made. And they will have a chance of winning huge jackpots. And if you remember these jackpots that I actually mentioned earlier, this is like a lottery, okay? So whenever there's a burning mechanism that activates in Pandora, the proceed of that goes to the jackpot, okay? And that is where the users can earn or get more rewards. So in Pandora, guys, apart from staking, is they actually have something called yield farming. Okay, so yield farming is actually where you provide liquidity and earn token rewards. Pandora also has something called NFT farming or NFT farmers, where you can own NFTs, stake your NFTs, and have the voting rights, okay? And then you have a chance of winning huge jackpots also by having this NFTs and earn a portion of the protocol's revenues. So this NFT farming, guys, is actually one of the key features or highlight features of Pandora, because not only will you be able to have a chance to earn, but you can also win huge jackpots through this. And remember I mentioned earlier, guys, that Pandora actually has two kinds of tokens. So the reward token is called Pan, guys, and that's the reward that you can get when farming. Now, guys, the Pan token or the reward token is so important, guys, because this is what you can use to buy or craft Pando boxes for you to get NFTs. And when you have an NFT, guys, then you can farm for more rewards and have a joint ownership of the protocol, because you get proceeds, guys, like a percentage of the fees or whatever actually goes to NFT farmers. At the same time, you will be able to participate in voting. So it's kind of like a DAO in a sense, and then you earn dividends, of course. And this is actually Pandora's joint ownership model, because basically you are able to convert traders, yield farmers, and external investors all into NFT farmers, which would then give them joint ownership. So this is Pandora's ecosystem in a nutshell, guys. Basically, there's swaps and trade mining. They also even have an IDO launchpad. And this is for the jackpot. This one is Pandoverse. Then we've got Pando Market. And then pools and farms. Then, like I mentioned earlier, guys, there is actually two tokens within Pandora. And the first one is the PSR, or the governance token, which is, there's going to be an airdrop on that one. So I mentioned it earlier in the video, make sure to check that out. And then the reward token, which is the Pandorium or PAN, which is going to be the reward token of Pandora. Now, what's going to make Pandora Spirit or PSR valuable, guys? It's because, guys, of PSR's utility, which during on phase 1 would be staking PSR to earn PAN and then paying droid bot upgrade fees. It's going to be used also for jackpot payouts, purchasing NFTs on Pando Market, paying Pando Market commission fees, reserving slots for staking droid bots, and crafting Pando boxes. Then we've also got phase 2, which you can use PSR to participate in voting, purchasing tokens on IDO launchpad, and then purchasing lottery tickets, and for serving as the governance token in future project. Now, PSR, guys, is a good burning mechanism, because PSR is going to be used for paying for slots, for paying for upgrading droid bots, for paying for crafting Pando boxes, and also it's going to be required for participating in IDO. So the burning mechanism of PSR ensures that as more users join the protocol, fewer PSR tokens will exist in circulation, making PSR valuable in the long run. Now, the PAN or our reward tokens utilities are for crafting Pando boxes in phase 1 and purchasing co-branded NFTs under the framework of the collaboration between Pandora and other DeFi projects on phase 2. Basically, guys, this Pando boxes is where you can get droid bots for you to be able to farm here in Pandora. And this is Pandora's core offerings, guys, which I actually discussed quite briefly earlier. And this is something that you can actually check in the pitch deck of Pandora. Now, you can actually try trading, guys, using the testnet. And this is the instructions, guys, to be able to do that. Basically, you can go to Binance Smart Chain Faucet, get some BNB, and then get USDT at testnet.pandora.digital/faucet-smart. Just input your wallet address right here, then submit. Then once that's done, guys, you can use BNB or USDT on testnet.pandora.digital/swap to try out the testnet. So I'm going to show you real quick how this is going to work, guys. Again, just go to testnet.pandora.digital/swap. Make sure you are in BSC testnet in your MetaMask or in your wallet. And then, guys, go to swap, and then you can click any currency that you want. Make sure to connect your wallet first. Choose MetaMask or whatever wallet that you have. And then once that's connected, you can choose a currency that you want to exchange to, like for example, PAN. And then I'm going to enter an amount, let's just say 0.5 BNB. And then I'm going to click on swap and then confirm.
Then all you need to do is to confirm the transaction in MetaMask, and that's it. You're done. It's that easy. Now remember, guys, that if you want to join the Pando drop, you can still do so until May 16, 2022. So you still have time if you want. But please always remember, guys, that even though I review these things, I always encourage you to do your own research first before you decide to join or enter anything that's crypto related. So in order to do that, do visit their website, pandora.digital, and also follow their social media accounts. Go, go, go!